Hey guys, Kieran from the Street Soccer International Team. Today we're going to take a look at three street skills known as clamps. Clamps or crippler. I call one of them crippler because that's how it was introduced to me when I was taught it. But clamps are just skills we can add into combos, or we can like utilise while we're playing and we want to create a moment for a player to come towards us. These can create stop motions that will allow then for us to play. They're in combos, we tend to utilise them just mainly to create cool looking effects. But the skill itself is very effective in terms of just clamping, creating a moment that a player is going to come and then we can kind of get away. The first one is the common clamp. Is we're going to like, however we're going to do it really, we can be in a combo here to set it up, or we can just tap it out. And all you're essentially going to do is the weight of the foot is going to be placed on the ball on top here, and you're resting your ankle down on the floor. So the weight goes onto the ball to clamp it down, and the ankle rests on the floor. So we can be into combos to set it up and jump into it a little bit. It opens our body in street, we can turn with it. So again, just so you notice, strong foot, whichever foot you're going to do it with, the toes put the weight down onto the ball initially, and then this ankle just rests down. If you're a young kid doing this one, you're going to need a smaller ball to do it. I've tried to do it with some kids, and when they're using even a size 3, it's a little too big for their ankles. But yeah, it's just weight onto the ball and just rest your foot onto the floor. The next one I call a crippler is because how it was introduced to me and the way it looks and feels is a crippler. So with the crippler, it's opposite way. This time it's the weight gets distributed onto the heel and the toes rest on the floor. So with this one, I tend to do it into combos where I'm moving into a sole roll down. So it's like a sole roll motion. The heel puts the weight on and then this foot just places the stabilization onto the court by just resting. Again, I tend to do this one mainly just for combos. We can step from the ball and create little movements. They're just fun little skills you can utilize and add into street combos in general. We can go into a clamp, over into the crippler, and have a little bit of fun with the ball. The next one is the double. A lot more dangerous because you're going to use both feet to do it. And we tend to see this when it's in a combo, we tap it out first. So that gives us the time then to jump into the ball. Now, this ball is not fully deflated, it's semi-deflated, and this makes it a little bit more easier to do this skill with on a street ball than a fully pumped up ball. Some people like these balls really flat. I'm not so much of a fan of that. It allows them to do certain pop-ups better, but because I do football as well, but because I do kind of regular football as well, I like to have that kind of in between where the ball's really got good grip and firmness, and with a little bit of deflation in it, so it's not rock solid, you're going to break your feet on it. But yeah, so with this one we'll tend to tap it out, and it's both feet are going to go into the clamp. So you're going to get both feet into a position to jump. So as we tap, we go into an area here, and what you're going to do is jump with both feet to get onto top of the ball. So both feet will get on top of the ball, so just have the ball standing still to practice. Both toes are going to put the weight down on the ball. Now, we might actually put a little bit more weight on our heels on this one and distribute the ball, the weight more to our, so we don't fall back. It depends on how you want to do it. But essentially, the toes of both feet grip the ball, push into it, and then jump down, and then just rest. So for me, this is definitely more street combo stuff that I'll be doing this skill into. but we can play with them and add them all. Oh, I missed it. And just create cool, nice combinations from them and have a little bit of fun. That's kind of good, I've not practiced for a while. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. A cool little, three cool little clamp skills utilizing street football. I suppose you could even add a fourth in and go into a double crippler. I've never done it until then, but I don't think it's something I'm going to add into myself more often. But yeah, you could do the crippler as well in that motion as well. I hope you've enjoyed this video, had a little bit of fun, tried something different and had a bit of fun with the ball. That's the main thing with street football and freestyle football. We remove the limitations of regular football and have fun. And just experiment and adapt and utilize things for our own creativity in play. Thanks for watching. Please leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, hit that bell notification button to stay up to date with future videos, and I'll see you in the next one.